So as you can see, it's dark. I'm in the Tesla Model Y again, and because you all seem to like the last adaptive beam video I made, I'm going to do another one today and look at the new adaptive high beam system that Tesla have only just released a matter of days ago. But this time, just look at what it does when you enter roads that are lit with streetlights. Because I didn't cover that particularly well on the last video, and I'm just going to get to grips with actually what the system does when you're driving on streetlights. And what's also prompted me to make this is a few people have posted online in the Facebook groups to say they've got the new software and it's never been enabled for them. Well, that's not right. They're saying that it doesn't actually switch on to high beams at all. And I suspect that's because they're driving in towns which has got streetlights. So anyway, I'm going to drive to a town that's got some streetlights and we'll see what the system does. It's also raining, so it's a good test to see whether there's been any changes to the automatic wipers, because it's well known that they don't work particularly well on the Tesla. But of course, to make the adaptive high beams to work, the camera's got to see out of the windscreen properly, so the auto wipers also need to work properly. But anyway, we're on a country road here, no street lights. The lights are up at full brightness, not that you can see that on the camera because the camera's not picking it up as well as I can see. But the high beam blue light is on the main screen with the A in it, which means it's got the adaptive lights on. And because it's lit blue, we're on main, you know, we've got the adaptive system on, and currently we're on full main beam. So as we enter the 40 here, the lights have just dipped. But that would have been because of the street lights, not because of that van that's just passed us, because the camera couldn't see that at the time. So we're now in an area that's lit with street lights, and the adaptive system is still on, but my lights are dipped. So as I'm driving through this road with street lights, the headlights have dipped down, but they're still on adaptive, and it does that pretty much every time you drive anywhere that's lit with any form of street lighting, or what I found in my other video, even just driving past a pub that was lit, it dipped the lights. But what I found just a few minutes ago driving down here is that it took the system off completely, and it went from high beam, i.e. the blue light, down to dip lights, and the little symbol turned grey. However, it's not doing it now, and I've just driven down this same road off camera and the system effectively disabled, but it's not doing it. So it's something to do with the ambient light, but obviously the ambient light hasn't changed. Well, it's got a little bit darker actually, so maybe it has measured a difference, because it's currently 8:30 and 15-20 minutes ago it would have been that little bit lighter. So is that the difference? Right, I've just looked at my screen and now the blue main beam symbol has gone to grey, and I haven't touched the stalk. Now it's gone back to blue. So it is measuring the ambient light, i.e. the lights from the light from the street lights. And if it's brighter or there's more street lights, then the system does disengage and just goes to standard dipped lights. But we're now back on a blue symbol with the A in it, and it's doing the adaptive lighting. So let's try another lit road and see if I can see that working again. Because while this has got street lights, they are quite a long way apart and not on both sides of the road here. On the left hand side, they're only on the other side of the path. So I'll just turn left at this roundabout and we'll see what the lighting is like down here. So here they're on both sides of the road, but we do have a path on the other side again. So the road isn't particularly bright, and at the moment it's still staying on adaptive high beams. And as you can see, that roundabout sign in front of us is reflecting a lot of light back because the lights are up. But they're, even though they're up, they're not as bright as full main beam. It does still dip when you're in a street lit area. So I've just looked back at the screen again and it's changed. It's now gone back to dipped beam and we've got a grey symbol on the dash. So the difference here must be there's more street lighting, there's more ambient light. Look at that, I've just looked again and it's gone back up to blue and it's now on adaptive high beams. So I think that's what other people have seen when they've said that my adaptive lights aren't working, is I'm sure it's because they're driving in towns and cities which have lit roads and therefore the car is deeming it not dark enough to have high beams and adaptives on. So I've turned around again and let's go and find another area lit with street lights. So I'm now driving on an unlit road. The headlights went to full beam there but immediately dipped because that car's coming the other way. And it's giving me a lot more light on the left-hand side of the road, even when those cars were going past. So I'm on full main beam now. There's a car just about to come over the brow of the hill here. There it is. And the right-hand headlight has dipped down. And look at that, he's flashed at me. So they're obviously still too bright for him. But that's a road where he was lower than I was because there was a gradient there, and that's where I found that other people might still flash, is when you're higher than them and they're still getting dazzled. So we've got some cars coming towards us now. The auto wipers are working very well and he didn't flash. And I could tell he was in a dark area, as it were. My headlights weren't lighting him up and keeping him in the dark. Yet I'm on the left-hand headlight. I can see the bank lit much further than I could with dipped headlights. So the adaptive side of things, when you're on a flat road, they work incredibly well. Tesla really got it right first time. The other little areas where it doesn't work quite so well is junctions and when there's a gradient on the road and you're higher and the cars might be lower. But I'm sure they will improve it slightly with future software updates. So this road is lit with street lights. They have dipped slightly, but not full dip. So they've just dipped again because of those cars. So when there are street lights, it's somewhere between dip beams and, oh sugar, I forgot about that pothole there. There's a particular nasty pothole there which will break alloy wheels. I completely forgot it was there. I was looking at the beams of the light and forgot about that. That's, I was lucky that didn't damage the wheels. But anyway, let's go and find another town to drive through and see what the lights are doing when it's lit. So I'm on an unlit A road here, coming up to a roundabout that is lit with street lights. I've got the blue light on, adaptive main beams are on. And they are dipped because there's not much reflection from that roundabout sign in front of me. This street light's just on the right hand side of the road, but it's still got the blue main beam adaptive light on the screen. and now the street lights have gone and my lights are back up. So all of that is working very well. So I'm now approaching another bit of lit road, but it's only lit on the right hand side, as you can probably see. But the lights have dipped down. There, I don't know whether you noticed that, but the roundabout was lit up and then the lights dipped down on both sides because of the street lights. There's no cars about, but the lights are still very bright, so they're not fully dipped. They're in that in between dipped and main beam. Yeah, they're quite high at the moment. As you can probably see, that sign on the left is lit up quite brightly. There's a car coming, but I didn't notice the lights change, but it's obviously not dazzling him on the right hand side. So some people have asked about pedestrians as well, so I'm going to try to look at that. I've just noticed we passed two pedestrians there, but I've got a car in front, so the lights are lower on both sides because of that car in front of us. But certainly if there isn't a car in front, then the left-hand headlight would be brighter and it will dazzle pedestrians if they're facing us, me. But we'll see if we can find some pedestrians in a minute to annoy and test that out. So as I come up behind this car, you can see my headlights aren't really lighting that car up until now. So they are very low, yet on the screen it has still got the blue main beam light lit. So I've just pulled away from these traffic lights here and I've noticed that the blue main beam light has turned to grey. Now it's gone back to blue. So I'm pretty sure it is measuring the light from the street lights. But so far the auto wipers seem to be doing a very good job. There's only the lightest drizzle on the screen, but as you can see, it did two wipes there, but it is wiping at about the right time. Obviously, the priority here, as far as the car's concerned, is to keep the screen clear for the camera to properly see. But it's not swiping the wipers too much. If I was doing it myself, I probably wouldn't swipe it as often, but it's not like the wipers are being dragged across a dry windscreen. So the lights, the adaptive high beams, have just come on again. So I wasn't looking. Is that because there were less street lights? Yeah, it's gone grey again, so they've turned themselves off. But then here we've got... Right, they've turned themselves back on again, so I've got the blue light on again, even though we've got street lights on both sides of the road, but it's not that bright. So I've been trying to look whether it's speed related as well, and it's not. Because I'm doing 15 miles an hour at the moment, now 20 miles an hour, and the adaptive lights are on. Because it's raining this evening, there's just not going to be any cyclists and pedestrians around, so I can't show you how the lights react to them tonight, but maybe I'll do that on another video. But so far, so far the auto wipers are working very well, and at the moment the screen is getting very wet and they're not swiping, so I'm going to manually swipe them there. And now they've gone full speed. That's a bit weird. I thought they were working better, but clearly not. Let me just check. Yeah, they're still on auto. But what I've hopefully tried to show you, which it may well not be coming out on the camera, is that the adaptive lights are dipping when there's street lights around and when the roads are being lit by the street lights. It's not dipping to full dipped beam, it's somewhere between dipped and main beam, but then they do dip again if cars come. But if there's a lot of street lights, then the system disables completely. But at the moment it's quite light here and we're still on the blue light. Now, as I said, that's gone to grey because it is quite light here, so they have just disabled. But clearly the amount of ambient light there is from the street lights is being measured, and it affects how the adaptive main beam system works, and it makes it disable if there's a lot of light about. So it all makes sense, but I'm not sure whether that's coming across on the camera. But anyway, I'll wrap it up for this video. If you've liked it, as always, please do click the thumbs up. That really does help. Also subscribe to the channel if you want to know more about the Tesla Model Y. Then there's a playlist in the video description where you can see other videos I've made. And the other thing I'll just say is, if you're subscribed to the channel, please make sure you've clicked the bell icon to get the notifications, because what I'm finding is, while many people are subscribed, unless they've got the notifications on, they aren't seeing the videos. And finally, if you're thinking about taking a Tesla test drive or ordering a new Tesla, please do use my referral code, which is in the video description below. You get benefits for doing that, and I also get some referral points which I can purchase Tesla products and merchandise and stuff like that with. So it's a win-win for both of us. And while I've been making Tesla videos for probably 3 years now, that code has never been used until someone called Josh very kindly used it last week. And I've now seen the benefit, so I'm going to start promoting my referral code a little bit more on videos when I remember. Okie doke, I'll see you on the next one.